I scream, you scream, we're all screaming for something completely different. Let's talk about it. Hey Lambo, what's up brother, what you watching? Oh, damn, some crazy ass shit happening in Mexico City. Why are they, oh, some feminist stuff? Are you sure? I don't know, man. You know, there's a lot of these protests happening all over the world right now, and it seems like we're getting a lot of misinformation. You know, maybe this will be a great topic for a video.
Oh, well, what do you know? You guys are here, and I got the camera on, and I got everything set up, you know, to make the video, so I might as well just make the video. Hi guys, welcome back. Hope you guys are having an amazing day today. And quick caveat, or quick little whatever, I apologize ahead of time for the noise. Let's just fast forward. What happened was, is that I'm sure that you guys have already seen it by now, that there's been those protests in Mexico City, and some guy punched a reporter, and you know, there's a lot of violence going on in Mexico City because the women are protesting, and again, I just come from the US, all right, right now, where there's a lot of women protesting all the time for all kinds of things. So, you know, again, it could get easily misrepresented as to what's going on out here. But I'm just gonna cut to the chase. What happened in Mexico was that this is not like some rural area. Again, this is Mexico City. And by the way, I'm only, please do not get discouraged as to, oh my God, Mexico's violent, Mexico's horrible. No. It's not, okay? It's just, again, Baltimore, South Chicago, Miami. There's plenty of places that are just as dangerous or more dangerous, okay, than here. I don't wanna get, this is not what this video is about. But anyways, this is exact same story also happens in the US and all over the world. Four police officers kidnapped a 17-year-old and raped her. The 17-year-old went to the police station in order to get this, you know, reported, and long story short, the victim becomes even more victimized, and not only are the four cops still in action, you know, the four cops still working like nothing happened, but now the police is going after the poor 17-year-old for even thinking of trying to go after these cops. And again, you know, what was she trying to do? What happens in the US when you get raped? You get a rape kit and you go through that whole motion. Well, it's the same kind of situation out here. And they botched the whole thing, they messed up the whole thing. And again, what happened was that the police came out and they started saying and started backing the four officers that raped. They started backing you know, being in favor of the raping and being in favor of this whole situation. And the people just weren't having it. Now, why weren't the people having it? It goes beyond a little bit further than the rape. It turns out, I did not even know this until my girlfriend and her friends and you know, my own research, you know, figured out what the fuck is going on out here. But you know how in India, you know, women get raped like that and it's a major problem? Well, guess what happens out here too? And nobody's doing anything about it. But again, this is not going to happen to you, you know, coming out here as, as an expat, as someone, you know, that's an international traveler, blah, blah, blah. No, no. I'm talking about a typical Mexican woman, most likely poor, most likely just regular, you know. They are treated out here just like the black people are treated in the U.S., meaning they get killed all the time. They get arrested all the time. They get abused all the time. Everything that goes with what happens to blacks, except for the rape. And I was like, nah, that can't be. And then I started seeing and, you know, getting enlightened a little further as to, you know, the machismo culture out here. Because again, I come from a very machismo culture coming, you know, born and raised as Cuban. But being out here in Mexico is like, it's a completely different machismo, you know, just like you might see in India or other parts of the world in which the women really have absolutely no right, no say, no nothing, and it's completely ass backwards. So, you know, fast forward to, again, the story as I was watching it today, and this is why I was prompted to make the video today, was the fact that it was misreported. It was just saying that, you know, there was a feminist you know, pink hat wearing a protest, a feminism protest, and in that protest, it turned extremely violent, you know, Antifa style. And again, it got violent, but the reason it got violent is not because it was, again, people are just misrepresenting it, saying, oh, it's a feminist march movement that got way out of hand. But that's not what it is. Literally, they're protesting. The women are protesting because enough is enough. They're tired of getting raped. And, you know, I find that as a good reason to, you know, protest. And then when they don't listen to you, then you got to go hard or go home. So I'm all in favor of all that. You know me. I talk about this shit all the time. I tell you guys to fucking hit the streets and stop protesting, you know, fucking monkey abuse. Okay, and start protesting, you know, why the fuck is my paycheck suck? Why the fuck am I starving? Why, you know, like real things. Okay, so, you know, I'm all about that, all right? So, you know, even as I was talking to my girlfriend and her girlfriends, you know, we were all, you know, literally discussing, you know, again, they understand it's like, yeah, right now, I don't care about higher wages. I don't care about having a better job. I just don't want to get raped anymore. And I was bringing it up to the group because, you know, it was a bunch of guys, a bunch of people talking. And I was bringing it up to the group. It's like, yeah, guys, but because a lot of the guys were against this shit. Just like guys are against this stuff in the U.S. In the U.S. is a completely different story. I'm on the guy's side in the U.S. That's another story for another day. But here, I'm like, guys, you know, right now, you know, it's just like, you don't want to get raped. The biggest fear a man has is getting raped. Okay? Period. End of story. So why the fuck are we allowing for our loved ones, again, mom, sister, girlfriend, every single female out there to get raped openly without any repercussion whatsoever? Because again, just like in the U.S., you can kill a black person without any, or you can do whatever the fuck you want to a black person, unfortunately, and without any repercussion, okay? And again, I'm not condoning any of that, obviously, you know, but it's just, I'm just, you know, putting out their truth, all right? One of the reasons I left the fucking U.S. is because even though I'm an American white guy from the outside, my name is Josearteaga, and again, you already know the route I'm going. I definitely don't get treated as bad as a black person, but I get treated pretty fucking bad in certain areas. And for those of you guys that have been following my channel for a long time, you guys have plenty of proof of that. You guys already know what's up. But again, that's not what this is about. This is about talking about misrepresentation of what's going on. Now, right now, you know, the people that are in power in here in Mexico are also misrepresenting this and making sure that the international world and this protest on the international stage is also looked at completely wrong. Because if people were to actually know why they were protesting in Mexico, then I think the good majority of the world, and especially the first world, would be like, oh damn, for reals? Okay, again, just imagine this mass protest happening in Los Angeles, in Seattle, and what are they protesting? Stop raping women. You know what I mean? And then there's groups of men that are defending the men and saying, no, we reserve our rights to continue raping without any problem. So that's basically what's going on here, which is insane. Now, I hear that coming out of India, I know India's pretty advanced out there too. Shout out to all my Indian homies. But you guys know that in India, you guys are going through that same shit too. All right, now India and Mexico are completely different, but they're not. They're very alike in many, many, many aspects. This, unfortunately, is one of them. Okay, and again, you know, these are the things that we need to talk about. Right now, they're protesting in India. Now we're gonna just go around the world real quick before we come back to Mexico. But, you know, right now, you know, they're protesting in India. Now, you would obviously think right after I just finished talking that, oh, this is a perfect segue. They're probably protesting rapes. No, they're not protesting rapes at all. When they do protesting the rapes, it's a similar situation to what's happening in Mexico, and it's only the women, and they have to go up against the men as well. Yeah, I know, kind of fucked up, right? But I digress. Why are they protesting in India? You want to know why? They're protesting the banks. And they're protesting because every single day, India is coming out with brand new news in which they are not, you know what I mean, in favor of cryptocurrency, are not in favor of cash, they're not in favor of anything. In fact, they want to have total 100% control of their currency and their people, and they keep saying it over and over again. And so their next move, which again, something I read today, is that India now wants to ban debit cards. And they want you to use a version, some system that they haven't even created yet, a system that is gonna be like the, it's gonna be like an Indian cryptocurrency. But again, they want to ban straight up all around every single use of Bitcoin or cryptocurrency and anything of that nature. And at the same time, right now they remember they've already banned cash. Been very unsuccessful. And again, in a country that 90%+ of the population uses cash, they banned cash. It didn't work. They're gonna try it again. Now they're trying to ban debit cards, and they want people to, you know, jump on the system. Which again, it's happening here in Mexico too, because, you know, my girlfriend, she can't even make regular fucking purchases on her debit card. She has to, you know, the other day she was at the bank for 2.5 hours just so they can approve a simple purchase that was under, you know, in dollars terms, probably like $150 to $200. Pretty crazy, right? And on top of that, you know, her debit card is pretty much useless. She had to go there so that they can activate this special thing on her phone, an app, a bank app on her phone that would also act as a debit credit card. And that is what she would have to be using in the future for, you know, any kind of debit, you know, digital purchase. Her debit card is useless now. It's kind of crazy, right? It doesn't make much sense. Now, I'm sure that someone with money and resources out here in Mexico might not have to go through all that. But notice how someone that's super duper crazy poor, she's not really poor. I don't want to get into that, you know, but I'm just saying in terms that the first world might understand, super crazy poor. And look at what the banking system makes her do. And again, you know, I've been talking about this many, many times before, that the banking system is just licking their chops because they want to come into places like Mexico and India and all over the place, and they just want to impose themselves on there. And again, just like in India, they're doing it here too. They want to ban debit cards, they want to ban cash, they want to set up a banking infrastructure. You know, when I was looking at the video from the banking system in India as to what they want to do, I was like, get the fuck out of here. And they want to do, and they really think that they're gonna be successful in doing this, you know, implementing this whole system, like getting rid of everything. It's just like insane. And I look at this, you know, just like I'm seeing it here in action in Mexico, and I'm just scratching my head and laughing, you know, just like a lot of people are scratching their heads and laughing in India, like, really? You know, like what people are saying, it's like, you do know that we have this stuff called Bitcoin and cryptocurrency that's already 100 times better than the actual banking system. And the banking system that you're actually trying to implement here is 1 billion times worse than the one that is already in use. And you want us to use this piece of shit system and not use this amazing other system? And, you know, so again, you know, the banking system is dead in the water, you know, before it even gets started. And this other stuff, this crypto stuff, is, you know, again, to the moon and beyond. But again, that's not what this video is about. This video is about all the shit that's going on around the world. In fact, I made a list. Oh shit, wait a minute. I made a list and I couldn't find it. It's literally because I had it in my hand and I made it into fucking origami here. But the thing is that right now, just like, you know, Mexico and India, there's tons of protests and nobody knows why the fuck they're protesting. You know, my God, I can't believe I fucked this up. You know, there's protests happening all over the world right now and people have no idea what the fuck is going on. Everything is getting misrepresented. The next protest we're gonna talk about is gonna be Hong Kong, because a lot of people don't know what the fuck is going on there, okay? They just don't know, all right? And guess what? I know a little bit. I don't know, I don't know anything. All I know is I don't know shit. But actually, I was in the same camp as probably most of you guys, probably 95% or more of you guys, that think that the protests in China have to do with just basic extradition laws. And that's it, you know, meaning like, because I even reported it, I'm sure, in other videos or live streams where I probably misquoted, misrepresented what was going on as well, because I didn't know. But it wasn't until I got, you know, actual news from people living in China that I was like, oh, wait a minute. Again, in China. Oh, and in Hong Kong. Okay? So let's explain what's going on here. What the protests are about is because China is trying to pass Now, it's not really China. It's the people in Hong Kong, meaning the representatives of Hong Kong, okay, are trying to pass an extradition law so that China, okay, can extradite people from Hong Kong. So meaning if you're in China and you escape China, you know, you have a crime and you committed a crime in China and you go to Hong Kong, well, according to the laws as they stand today, and the same thing goes for Taiwan, by the way. If you don't know that too much of the history about Taiwan, Hong Kong, and China, you should look into that a little further. But China is its own entity. Even though Taiwan is its own separate country and Hong Kong is its own separate entity, they kind of belong to China. But again, it all depends on who you ask for. If you ask the US or Taiwan, they are their own thing. If you ask China, China belongs to Taiwan. Taiwan belongs to China. Same thing with Hong Kong. Hong Kong belongs to China, but it doesn't. Hong Kong is its own separate entity. I don't want to get into it. That's not what this is really about right now. What's going on is that the fact sense, all this is weird right now, or for a while, there's no extradition laws for people in Hong Kong. So what does that mean? That means that me, Jose Arteaga, can just commit murder, fly to Hong Kong, and they can't extradite me. What? Yeah, exactly. So when I first heard this shit, you know, the previous stuff, meaning I was thinking to myself, oh, China, it just wants to pass this law so that they can go after, you know, people that disagree with their government. You know, they can go after people that are anti-communist, the people that are, you know, whatever, you know, that failed the social score. I don't know. This is, you know, what people think. But the reality, that's not what happened. What prompted this case and these protests is because someone from Taiwan committed murder, rape and murder, I think, I'm pretty sure, but I don't know, those things, horrible, and he escaped to Hong Kong, and they were trying to extradite him to Taiwan, and they couldn't. You know why? Because there was no system, no laws, there was no infrastructure set up so that he can, be, you know, he can, you know, so they can, because remember, everything's bureaucratic nowadays, okay? And it's been for forever now. But since there's no bureaucratic system, no bureaucratic infrastructure, so that, you know, when they want to extradite this violent criminal, they can't. So again, right now they want to extradite this guy, but they can't. And so there's a lot of cases like that. And when looked in, when looked at even deeper, it seems that the only people that they want to extradite are those very violent criminals. And I was like, oh, wait a minute. Well, this makes 1,000% sense. And in fact, if I was a Hong Kong resident, I would want that law to be passed. Simply because if not, then every violent criminal within the area is gonna wanna come and live in Hong Kong for obvious reasons. You follow? And that just would continue to snowball and become an even more worse situation that it already is, only because, well, not everybody's watching this. Wow, I've already gone over 21 minutes. It's a long ass fucking videos today. But that's what's happening in Hong Kong. Now, I'm not fucking sitting here trying to, you know, be on one side or the other. I'm just letting you know what the hell's going on. You know, because people are just thinking, like, oh, they're just trying to extradite, you know, people, you know, that don't agree with communism. It's like, really? Well, maybe they want to also extradite people that are, you know, fucking murderers and rapers and all this other shit in between. So again, that's why we need to really look even deeper as to what's going on. But again, I still have only touched on 2, maybe 3 countries. But right now, let's just go through the list. There's protests in the USA all the time. There's protests in Paris every fucking week. In case you're not aware, the yellow vest, the gilets jaunes, okay, which is, I'm sure that there's protests all over the world now in which people are now wearing their yellow vest. Which, by the way, let me give you a little cultural context on revolution. Remember, the first major revolution of peoples wanting to be free and create a free land was the, you know, Revolutionary War, the revolution of 1776, you know, the US of A against Britain, bomb, bomb, you know, yada, yada, yada. We set up the United States of America, the first free land, right? I say that loosely, in the world. And after that happened, other places around the world looked at the US's revolution, they looked at the success of that, and they wanted to do the same. The next in line was France and the French Revolution. I'm sure you've heard of it. that happened, and so on and so forth. So right now, with the French Revolution that's happening today, that's been ongoing for almost a whole year now, as all these other protests are blossoming all around the world, there's a lot of influence straight from there, where you're seeing these people that are wearing yellow vests in protests all around the world, and they were basically all influenced and all encouraged to do so by the success of what's happening in France. Now, again, what's happening in France right now, which is the longest running protest at this moment of all of them that we're talking about, it could be, it's either a success or not, depending on who you're looking at, okay, who you're talking to right now. But there's still protesting and there's still no change, and it's almost a year now. It's pretty crazy. Yeah, Paris, fucking France. But anyways, I just gotta repeat it because I'm sure there's a lot of you guys that don't even know what the hell's happening in France right now. But again, crazy protests in France, crazy protests in India, in Brazil, Argentina, Spain, Greece, Bolivia, Algeria, Nicaragua, London, because of the whole Brexit thing. And that's it. That's what I've written down here, because I was going to continue writing more stuff down, but I was like, you know what? I think that's enough. All right. I think I got enough. And there's so many more other, cities that are all just at the brink of, we cannot take it anymore. All right. I'm going to insert here.
I'm as mad as hell, and I'm not going to take this anymore.
But, that's it. People cannot take this anymore. They've had enough. And, this is like a wildfire, As more of these things spark up, well, it just creates a greater, bigger fire. And even though a lot of these protests have nothing to do with each other, in the end, they all have to do with each other. And if you really look down, deep down, as to why everyone's protesting in one form or another, it's because they've had enough with the ultimate power that these people have over them. All right, and again, who are these people? I'm just talking about government. So, the people have had enough. Whether they're protesting the extradition laws, whether they're protesting rape, whether they're protesting the banking system in India, France, and so forth, and whether they're protesting independence, like in Catalonia and Spain, but it doesn't matter what the fuck they're protesting, okay? And again, when you go to Latin America, you're probably thinking they're protesting, it's just students protesting that they want more funds for their schooling, for their universities. Again, I know, you didn't think that's what they were gonna fucking protest down there, right? So that's what I'm saying. We don't know until we find out. But at the end of the day, it's all people pushing back against these big monstrosity of governments that are doing absolutely nothing but raping and pillaging the population. Yeah, all right, I was trying to fucking be literal there, okay? Like literal, what is it, like pun intended, okay? Because that's exactly what's happening, and people have had enough. Whether they've had enough with religion, and again, it's not to say that, they've had enough with religion per se, but no, they've had enough with the fucking popes and the cardinals and all this raping going on. There's a lot of people that have had enough with, again, they might love America like I do, but they've had enough with America and what's going on over there right now. You know what I'm saying? And so on and so forth. Just like in Mexico, all these women, they're very happy, they're very happy with their feminism movement out here, because again, it's not like in the US, women have power in Latin American countries and so on. But again, the protest is because they've had enough with getting raped. And again, I'm not just talking about, 17-year-old girls getting raped. No, they're raping grandmas. They're raping anything with a fucking hole in it. So they've had enough. Same thing as in India, and so on and so forth. You know what I mean? And the fact, it's just the fact of what we always talk about. Absolute power corrupts absolutely. And that's, basically where we're at. It doesn't matter what the fuck we talk about, because on this channel, whether we're talking about, Bitcoin and the financial system, whether we're talking about, what's going on with, again, the dollar and the world, what's going on with the, all these cultural things, whether it's what's happening here in Mexico with the raping or India, or what's happening with the, the protests of the banking, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't fucking matter. At the end of the day, it's all correlated. It's all the same thing. All humans, okay, we are all one symbiotic organism, okay? Literally, all of us, okay? And right now, the powers that be are trying to spin every single scenario, every single thing into pure negativity and horribleness. And we need to do the complete opposite. We need to, as a, you know, human species, collectively, you know, put in literally, what is it? Damn it, what's the word I'm looking for? Literally, put power, what is it? Put thought into power, power into thought. I don't know what the whole thing here. But again, our thoughts are more powerful than we think. And if we really demand a change, if we really, you know, go out there, and again, the demanding of the change can just come from within, and just demand that we, that you do not want to live in this kind of world anymore, that you do not want to accept this insanity anymore, that you will not accept any of the shit anymore, all right? And we start breaking through that, start breaking through that shell, start breaking through that insanity, which is, you know, the world that is today, then we do stand a chance. I really do think that we stand a major chance to go up against this beast that, I'm sorry, I'm just looking at the time because it might go over, but we stand a humongous chance to go up against this beast, okay? Like, for reals. And we're doing it. Because as I'm seeing all these protests and everybody just like mad as hell and they're not gonna take it anymore, for whatever the reason it is, at the end of the day, even though they're all different reasons, they're all the same reason. They're all stemming from the same kind of problem, all right? The same, you know, the same problem is giving different systems, the same problem is causing different symptoms in different parts of the world, but it's the same fucking sickness, the same disease that everyone around the world has had enough with, and we're all pushing back collectively in one form or another. All right, and that's all I really wanted to talk about, guys. At the end of the day, what's happening here in Mexico right now is only getting started. Just like you're seeing Hong Kong going on 3 months, you know, we're looking at Paris going on, I don't know, 9 months or more. I don't know, correct me if I'm, someone correct me down there. Mexico is just starting their first month, and so on and so forth. Okay, this revolution is worldwide. Okay, this revolution is a human revolution. Be a part of it. Do not be sitting on the fucking sidelines. All right? See, I knew the video was gonna stop recording. Again, guys, what, I don't know where it cut off, but again, what I, the last thing I was saying is that this is a worldwide revolution now, a human revolution now, okay? And you need to be a part of it. Period, end of story. You cannot sit on the sidelines. We cannot afford, as a human species, to be sitting on the sidelines right now. We need to get the control back. Period in the story, that's it. All right? I hope whatever the hell I was saying before wasn't cut off too much, because I thought I was like right at the end. But anyways, that's it, I'm done here. Obviously the whole thing cut off has been over half an hour. It's a very long episode, but there was a lot I had to say, and I really hope that you enjoyed today's episode. I really hope that you guys got the message. I really hope that you guys really, really, you know, are sinking in to all of this information that's being thrown at you. All of the, I hope a lot of you guys are really, you know, understanding this stuff. I hope today's episode was enlightening to you guys, okay? And you can use this to further, you know, your trip down the rabbit hole, to further your education, your knowledge. But again, just watching and listening is doing absolutely nothing. You need to do more, all right? You need to spread this knowledge. You need to start talking about these things. You need to start doing a little more, okay? I'm gonna ask you guys for a little more than just a thumbs up and a comment, because that's only helping me a little bit and might help one other person see this video. But right now we need to kick this into high gear. I need you to spread, you know, the knowledge behind this video. I need you guys to start doing your part, whatever that is, okay? You need to figure that out, okay? But you need to just do something, all right? Please don't do it for me. Don't even do it for you. Do it for the future of humanity. I know it sounds a bit crazy and a bit over the top, but the reality is that right now, we're in a very, very, you know, major infliction point, a major turning point in human history, and this could go either way. I am very optimistic, and I really do think that we can pull it out at the in the bottom of the ninth, and just like we always have as humans. But we cannot rely on the last batter in the bottom of the ninth with two strikes to save the fucking day. Okay? If we can save this game in the eighth inning, we gotta do it. We need to figure this shit out. Okay? Otherwise, there ain't gonna be nothing to figure out left, all right? It's just gonna be, you know, back to the Stone Age. There's an Apocalypse Now type of shit. And yeah, that situation could happen. But it's all up to you as to whether we're living in that scenario or we're living in the pretty awesome scenario. You know? You know what I'm talking about. We all have our own versions of the future. All right? So let's shoot for that. Guys, thank you so much for watching today. Thank you for being here. I love you guys to death more than you can imagine. Thank you for watching. For all of you guys that are still here, about, I don't know how long it's been already, 35 minutes later or whatever. Thank you, thank you, thank you from the bottom of my heart. But really, thank you for being interested in this stuff. Thank you for wanting to really talk about this stuff. Thank you. Thank you. Because you out there that are still watching right now are the few brave souls that really want to take this on. All right? And some of you are already doing it. Some of you are looking for a way. But at the end of the day, you are the soldiers out there that are going to be making a difference. There's a lot of us out there. In all capacities, some of them are probably not even, most of them are not watching this video. But for those of you guys that are and still watching this right now, I just want to say thank you. And I'm going to say a thank you for all the humans out there, all right? Thank you, all right? Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you, thank you. How many times did I say thank you, huh? Huh? I'll give a cookie out there to anyone that counted. But anyways, I'm done here. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please share, please hit that bell icon. Thank you to all my patrons. Thank you to everybody out there. Thank you to my sponsor, Jose and Lambo.
What?
And just thank you. I love you guys. Stay awesome, and I'll see you guys mañana. Peace.
Hey guys, guess what? Me and Lambo are still here. We haven't left yet. You know why we're here? Because I want to tell you all about this new store that I just opened up. Yeah, that's right. It's our new sponsor as well. Let me tell you a little bit more about it. So, as you guys can see, this is the store. I just opened up the store, I don't know, about a week ago, and I'm gonna be selling all my merch and all of our stuff here, whether it's Lambo stickers, whether it's, you know, mugs, t-shirts, jackets, you name it. We got all kinds of stuff that you guys can buy and help support the show. Now you get to have your very own shirt or your very own Lambo sticker. And if you guys want any special requests on things for me to put in the store, then please, by all means, let me know. And we'll get our graphic artist, you know, on top of it. Yeah, that means you gotta work, Lambo. All right, guys. Thank you so much. Love you guys, and I'll see you guys mañana.